Did you know that one player played all three events at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics? And out of the 172 badminton players who are playing, more than 70% of them are playing with Yonex badminton rackets. And besides Yonex, there are 10 other brands sponsoring all the remaining players. So let me show you who's playing with what racket at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. So I hope everyone has enjoyed the badminton event at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics, which featured 172 athletes from 49 NOCs, and enjoyed supporting our new Olympic champions along the way. So Victor Axelsen in the men's singles, Chen Yufei in the women's singles, Li Yang and Wang Qilin in the men's doubles, Grace Yapoli and Apriani Rahayu in the women's doubles, and finally Wang Yulu and Huang Dongping in the mixed doubles. So a shout out has to go to Doha Hani of Egypt for qualifying and playing in all three events which she was eligible for. So all the players have a common denominator. They needed a racket of their choice to play and win. So after going through a lot of footages and photographs, I can now tell you who's playing with what rackets at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics. I will also tell you how you can play with all the data that I've researched and compiled, so stick around to the end of the video to find out. So like I said at the start, so Yonex sponsored 124 out of the 172 players at the Tokyo Olympics. This equates to 72.1% of the players playing with a Yonex badminton racket. The next brand down from Yonex is Victor, and they have 19 players, or about 11% of them playing with their rackets, and followed by Li Ning with 15 players at just under 9% in total. We then have other brands such as Adidas, Babolat, Forza, Mizuno, RSL, Yang Yang, and two others that I could not identify. More on that later on. So in terms of the big teams, only China, Japan, Indonesia and South Korea had more than 10 players represented at the Olympics, with China having 14 players, Japan second with 13, Indonesia with 11 and South Korea with 10 players. So in terms of the Yonex rackets, I was able to identify 20 models which were used by the players at the Olympics, so it's such a super wide range of racket models, ranging from the latest ones to some old school racket models as well. So bearing in mind I did something similar like this for the Thailand Open Super 1000 event earlier this year, I was quite surprised to find a fair few players have changed their rackets in between this time. So the most popular series of rackets from Yonex was the Astrox series, which 71 out of the 124 sponsored players were playing with it. Second in line were the Nano Flares, the headlight models, with 25 players. The Doras were third with 12 players, and we had 8 Arc Saber players, all of which were Arc Saber 11s, and ending with 7 players going for the Voltrics. So now, as I'm going to be pronouncing a lot of players' names, I want to try and get each and every one of them correct as best I can. So please let me know in the comments section down below if I've got any of the names wrong, and tell me how to pronounce them correctly too. So the most popular racket amongst the pros at the Tokyo 2020 Olympics is none other than the Yonex Astrox 100ZZ, with 18 players playing with it. This means there are more than 10% of players at the whole of the Olympics playing with one single model of racket. So notable players playing with this racket would be the new men's singles Olympic champion Victor Axelsen of Denmark, Shi Yuqi and Chen Qingchen of China also uses this racket, alongside Akane Yamaguchi and Hiroyuki Endo of Japan. This is also Li Zijia's racket of choice as well. So the next most popular racket, which has 14 players playing with it, are shared across by two models, the Astrox 77 and the Nanoflare 700. We will start by looking at the 77 first. So notable players with the Astrox 77 include Chen Yufei, Huang Dongping and Huang Yachong from China, An Se-yong from Korea and Isabel Hetrich from Germany. The medium whippy and headlight Nanoflare 700 also have plenty of big name players playing with it. Michelle Lee from Canada, Arisa Higashino from Japan, and plenty of South Korean players such as Choi Yu-jung, Lee So-hee, Shin Seung-chan and Seo Seung-jae. The men's doubles Olympic champion from Taiwan, Wang Qilin, also plays with the Nanoflare 700, and finally Ratchanok Intanon from Thailand as well. Surprisingly or unsurprisingly, Wang Qilin and Seo Seung-jae were the only two men out of the 14 players using the Nanoflare 700. So next on the list was Kenta Momoto's racket of choice, the Sledgehammer Astrox 99, and alongside 10 other players who were happily playing with it. So notable names include Kevin Corden of Guatemala, who went all the way to the semis in the men's singles, causing quite a few upsets along the way. Kantapon Wangcharon from Thailand and Zhang Beiwen from the USA. So Beiwen was already a game up during her match against Herbing Zhou of China when the devastating injury happened to her. So I'm sending her a lot of love here and hopefully she makes a full and swift recovery. We hope to see her very, very soon. So we now have three models which had eight players using it each. The old and legendary Arc Saber 11, the Nanoflare 800 and the Astrox 88S Pro. So I'll look at the Arc Saber 11 and the Nanoflare 800 first. The Arc Saber 11 has been out for years and years compared to the newer model rackets, but there's just so much love for it. And it's an amazing racket, and players such as Matthias Christensen from Denmark, Choi Sol-Q from Korea, and also Aaron Chia from Malaysia, who had a bronze medal in men's doubles, and they're all happy playing with it. The Nanoflare 800 is also an amazing racket with so many players absolutely loving it. It is a headlight racket, but very, very easy to play with and can generate a lot of good power with good technique and timing. Players who are playing with it are Li Yang of Taiwan, who is the second half of the men's doubles Olympic champion alongside Wang Qilin, Tom Gikel of France, Du Yue and Jia Yifan from China, and Mayu Matsumoto of Japan. Whilst we're on the topic of the Nanoflare 800, I'd like to take your attention to three players playing with the Nanoflare 800 Lite. So the Nanoflare 800 Lite is a 5U super light model of the Nanoflare 800 racket. So this was surprising for me, as you would expect professional players who are well conditioned and super strong to be playing with slightly heavier and normal weighted rackets. These three players are playing with it are Setyana Mepasa of Australia, Herbing Zhou and Li Junhui of China. Now bearing in mind Herbing Zhou was still playing with the Nanoflare 800 in June during the Chinese Olympic simulation games, so she switched to the light model during the Olympics. Li Junhui on the other hand earned a silver medal in the men's doubles and is an amazing smasher. All he does is smash, and this just shows you you don't have to be using a heavy or a head heavy racket to have a big smash, something we can all learn from. So let's talk about the Astrox 88S Pro. As you're aware, Yonex has launched a Pro model in comparison to the previous generation for both the 88S and 88D. You can find out about all the differences between them in the video here. However, what I've found is plenty of players are sticking with the second generation models of the Astrox 88s, regardless between of the S or D models. So you can see here there are almost an equal amount of players playing with the second generation rackets as well as the current Pro models. This is completely down to their own personal preference and choice as a player to what makes them comfortable. For example, Wang Yulu of China, who is one half the mixed doubles gold medal Olympic champions, he used to play with the Astrox 88D Pro before swapping onto the second generation 88S for the Olympics. And ooh, whilst we're on the topic of swapping rackets, I also like to point out that I noticed Azerbaijan's Ade Reskidui Chahio was playing with the Astrox 88S in his first game against Anders Antonsen and swapped back to his usual racket of the Dora 10 after the mid-game interval. That was an interesting one, so go watch that if you can. So back to the Astrox 88s. Plenty of big name players are playing with all four models of rackets at the Olympics, so I'm going to pick a few here. For the 88S Pro, Kevin Sanjaya Sukamuljo, Stefani Soeva, Li Yinhui, Sayaka Hirota, Takeshi Kimura, Wakana Nagahara, Selena Peak, and Sapsiri Teratanachai, a super popular model. For the second generation 88S, we have Wang Yilu, Ben Lane, Godwin Olofa, Busana Nombang Rumpan, Dechapol Poavaranukro, and Mark Lamsfus, who was actually still playing with the Voltric 80E tune earlier this year. So the 88D Pro has players such as Marcus Fernaldi Gideon, Keigo Sonoda, Yuki Fukushima, and So Wu Yik, who needs no further introduction, alongside Li Meng Yen, Sonia Chia, and Wen Tuen Lin. Please let me know if I've got any of the names wrong, as I want to get them right. And finally, the second generation 88D, we have Marvin Seidel, Mark Kaliao, Ivan Sozonov and Vladimir Ivanov, Kim So-young, Neshli Hanyijit and Tang Chun-man. So after the Astrox 88s, we got a few players on a few other models such as the old school sledgehammer, the Voltric Z-Force 2, which Marcus Ellis, Lauren Smith, Sai Praneeth and Niluka Karunaratne playing with it. To view the complete 172 players and their rackets, I will leave a link in the description below to my website at ckyw.com and all the data in a blog post which are interactive and will allow you to sort via events or countries and see other players with their rackets alongside the stats as well. So I'm not too sure what other players outside of Yonex are playing with. For example, I think Chen Long was playing with an unreleased leaning model racket, so I've left them blank for now. I also wasn't able to determine two rackets, and they are from Brazil's Igor Coelho and Bulgaria's Linda Zichiri. Both of them did not have a stencil that I could recognize on their racket strings, so if you know what all the other players are playing with their specific models, please put them down in the comment section below and I'll be updating my post on the website to reflect these updates for the Tokyo 2020 Olympic rackets. So I hope you guys like something like this. Smash that subscribe button if you do. Go check out my blog piece and play with the data. I will see you in the next one.